Great. Thank you for joining us this evening. I have the great pleasure to talk with Dr. Sapna Sriram, who is the program director for a brand new course through the Schulich Executive Education Centre. And the program is a mini-MBA for clinical professional entrepreneurship. And the goal of this program is to provide the entrants, the students with a current and robust business competencies directly applicable to their clinical practices. So this mini-MBA for clinicians is really a one-of-a-kind program in Canada, and it's designed specifically for healthcare professionals and is focused on enhancing their business management skills to drive growth and profitability in their practices over the long term. The program will help clinicians with starting or expanding a new adventure, gaining fresh perspectives at how businesses and how business knowledge is evolving, and leading more customer-focused effective practices. And so it gives me great pleasure this evening to speak with Sapna, who is a leading Canadian chiropractor and registered acupuncturist with a focus on sports injuries, pre and postnatal care, and chronic pain. She's also an award-winning co-founder and CEO of Integra Health Center, Toronto's largest and most reputable collaborative full-service medical and health clinic. So Sapna, maybe we can talk about this amazing program that you've developed. And let's really start off with, why should clinicians take this program?
Well, first of all, thank you for having me, Michael. I'm really excited to be able to actually just talk about the program. And that's exactly it. Why should clinicians be interested? I think, you know, I say it so often, and I know you can relate, you know, we're in professional school, we're learning our craft and our skill set, and our focus primarily is really just passing our boards, being able to practice and really refining our skill set. But what often is usually fundamentally missing is the actual business knowledge and the acumen. And, you know, we get out of school, we have these great, you know, I guess, aspirations to be amazing at what we do. And, you know, we hear that saying that, you know, what makes a great doctor or a clinician or, a, you know, a dentist, you know, great at what they do often is their bedside manner. Less often, you know, you hear it in their actual skill set. And I think that resonates with not just your personality, but your ability to understand, you know, how your practice is so much of a business, how your patients, you know, and their experience actually matters to how well you do, you know, from a longevity perspective. And just in general, you know, there's just so much we don't know when we come out of school. And a lot of it is, you know, we're forced to just get this experiential learning, which is we learn from the clinic owner that we join a practice with, or, you know, we just kind of hop around and try to figure out what makes sense. And, you know, we learn it that way. But, you know, that's there's something to be said about practice and, you know, learning through experience. But there's also something to be said about how you can fast forward your learning journey from the business side of things by getting that fundamental, you know, fundamental education brought to you in a way that's actually relevant to you and condensed, so that you can actually be successful and also successful quicker, I would say.
Right. And so, you know, we're really, you know, our constituency here, we're talking to dental hygienists, mm-hmm. who, you know, who are some amazing clinicians who are out there. And really, I would say probably the newest form of clinical practices, where they're developing businesses that are focused on dental hygiene. And it's an exciting time. There's some courageous entrepreneurs out there who are sort of, you know, expanding their clinics. Mm-hmm. Some of them are starting out, and some of them are thinking, is this for me? So this is perhaps a great opportunity for some of these hygienists to really try to learn what it takes to be an entrepreneur. What would you say are some of the biggest struggles or challenges that clinicians or clinic owners have that you're sort of going to help address with this course?
Well, I think the biggest problems, and this is for, you know, like you said, there's so much innovation and disruption, and especially I see it. I have a lot of colleagues in the dental industry, and, you know, we're seeing it on so many different levels. And I think, you know, we all share some common challenges. And I think, you know, some of those just being not knowing where to start, being a big problem. And often what I also find is, like, you know, that you see the clinician that finally figures out how to start, but, you know, there's so much uncertainty because there's no plan for the exit. And I think, you know, so much of your business is weighed on your strategy from start to finish. And I think what's really great about this program is that it's giving you a broad perspective of not only what does it take for you to start a successful business, but fundamentally, how do you build those tools and those frameworks so that your actual plan for what your exit is going to be, whether that means you're selling it, you're scaling it, you're investing in your people to help you grow your business. You know, there's just so much that's involved in your business. And I think, you know, we don't really realize how much like risk there is in starting a practice or starting a business or whatever that might be for a hygienist, you know, especially in this day and time. I'm seeing so many new dentists on TikTok or hygienists on TikTok. And, you know, I'm just seeing so much amazing, amazing innovation with hygienists. And I just think that, you know, again, it's not something that we get in school. And so to be able to get the concepts of marketing, just not just beyond, you know, how to start a social media page, but really a marketing and branding strategy, you know, learning financials, like there's just so much that goes into, again, like, you know, there's your profit side of your business, there's your expense side of your business. And then there's really just trying to figure out how do you like really get a meaningful business started with good profits as well. And I think as healthcare providers, you know, we're almost like afraid to talk about that part of our business. Like we're here to help our patients, but we're also here to run a business, you know? And so this program is great because it's really just going through so many of the fundamental things that we just don't get in school. Like even the HR side of things, I think that's a big thing. Entrepreneurship and innovation, really just inspiring, you know, clinicians to really think outside the box. And, you know, just, I mean, like, you know, yourself, the program in itself with the coaching and the mentorship and being able to even run a real ROI project, so a return on investment project to help you launch or execute a challenge you're facing today. I think that in itself is going to be a great, great way for clinicians to like really catapult themselves into business quicker, or help them with a really big problem they might be having right now because they get entered into business and they don't really know what they're doing.
Right. I think, you know, your course is a great opportunity because I think there's great benefit in the mixing of the different types of clinical professions out there. And I think that there's going to be a lot of opportunity to learn from the different industries, right? And I think
100%.
That's an amazing advantage that you have. I mean, you know, the physicians, they're all physicians. The dentists, they're all dentists. And there's value, but I think you have the major advantage of just having such a diverse group of people. Maybe you can touch on the types of professions that are represented.
Yes. And I will say, you know, that was definitely a big criteria for this program. I was a little, you know, and I believe that, you know, I mean, you'll agree with me too. Innovation happens when you can collaborate. I mean, my whole business model and my entire career has always been around collaboration. And I do wholeheartedly see, you know, how much you can benefit from learning about mental health providers and nutritional providers to, you know, MSK providers. There's just so much that you can learn from so many different people. And so this program is great because it's a mixed bag. Like we have got nurses, we have chiropractors, we have physiotherapists, massage therapists, we have, you know, optometrists. We just have such a broad variety of healthcare clinicians and innovators. And what's good is that, you know, you'll be able to bring your perspectives, but you'll also be able to learn from other people's perspectives. And what you'll learn is that your actual clinical delivery models might be very different, but your actual experiences, challenges, you know, obstacles are all inherently very, very similar. And I use the same analogy as somebody who's in the food business, whether you are running a model that's about food trucks, whether your model is about fast food or fine dining. It doesn't matter the type of food experience, you all share very similar struggles. And you know, and that's why in healthcare, we really do need to learn from each other because we can get more innovation, we can get more ideas, and we can get more excited about what we want to achieve just by knocking heads with more people.
Right. And I think, you know, if you run this program for long enough, it has to be expected that somebody will come up, a group of your students will come up with a great idea of having a mixed clinical environment, right? Hygienists, exactly, with naturopaths, with chiropractors. I mean, it's inconceivable to me that that doesn't eventually happen because that would just make so much sense from a patient, from a delivery standpoint, and from a benefit, right? I mean, we live in a world where that has to be the next, that's the next frontier, correct?
Absolutely. And I mean, it's so interesting because I mean, even when I started my clinics, I didn't even think, you know, I knew it was definitely like cool to have a collaborative model, but you know, we soon became the biggest clinic in Toronto. And it was fascinating to me that, you know, this collaborative care model is actually something that is so underutilized. And a lot of it comes down to, again, the business models. It's not because they don't exist because they shouldn't. They don't exist often enough because it's the resources and the capacity of the business acumen that's missing. And clinicians are too afraid to take the risk because they don't know how to get started. Right. You know, and so, I mean, even just people listening.
Yeah, I think fear is probably the biggest hurdle that people need to get over. And it's now seems like it's a great time because money's mm-hmm. cheap, right? I mean, interest rates are extremely low. So if there's ever a good time, mm-hmm. now's the time. And maybe my last question is, what would be some of the misconceptions about ownership? As an owner yourself, what would you say some of these misconceptions are?
I think there's a misconception that you're either going into it because you just really want to make a lot of money, or you're going into it because, you know, it's the right thing to do. I think those are the two biggest things that I hear so often, more than not. And I think, you know, for those of the people that think it's what you have to do, I think there's a lot of amazing business opportunities that are existing. And we're seeing so many different structures evolving where junior associates, I'm even seeing hygienists in large dental clinics becoming clinic directors and clinic, you know, partners because of the sheer fact that their business acumen is so exceedingly, you know, entrepreneurial in nature that dentists are putting hygienists into these strong leadership roles to help them scale and grow faster. You know, so I do believe that, you know, it's very important to understand that there's a lot of growth opportunities and they don't necessarily always have to evolve to owning a clinic. But the misconceptions of clinic ownership is that, you know, people think that, you know, the owners just check out. There's, you know, there's not a lot of, once you have it set up, you can just put it on autopilot and, you know, never come back to it because other, you know, it'll just run for itself. And, you know, there's just so many of these things. And I do think that there's a lot of profit to be had and there's a lot of money to be made. But I do believe that, you know, the people that do always succeed are the ones that put in those systems in the beginning. And they really are invested in seeing their clinics grow and also seeing their people grow with it. And I think when you have that sort of secret sauce or that recipe, you see a lot of those owners that are finally getting to enjoy the fruits of their labor. But, you know, by having the, like a course or a program that's helping you along the way, especially in the startup phases, I do think that, you know, it's just something that owners, like they spend years making mistakes, expensive mistakes, figuring out a lot of this stuff. Like, I mean, you see it in the dental program, right? Like a lot of the curriculum is just like, geez, like if I knew all these things, you know, it would have helped me save a little bit of money in the start.
Well, I think, you know, this is a super exciting program. You know, you have my congratulations. And I just want to say to the hygienists out there who may be watching this, here's an opportunity for you to, number one, invest in yourself. Mm-hmm. There is, you know, education and knowledge is power. And I think that you owe it to yourself to do everything you can to maybe stretch yourself a little bit. Think about what the future may hold for you in your clinical practice and take ownership. And here's a great opportunity, an amazing program put together with the Schulich Executive Education Centre and with Sapna. So I wish you all good luck and I hope that you seize the opportunity. So good luck. Sapna, great. Good luck with the program.
Thank you so much.
Okay. And good luck. Good luck to all of you listening. So
hopefully I see some of you in the program.
I hope so. Okay. Good night, everybody.